And welcome back to Let's Play Castlevania Lament of Innocence. I'm Bupix, and almost gonna finish off this place now. I am obsessed with checking that map. I don't have a problem. I can stop whenever I want. And this is the door some of those switches opened up. Oh, hi, big mace guy. You're in my way. I mean, you're not actually in my way, but that's the excuse I'm gonna use. Stop glowing purple. Nobody likes purple. That's why everybody hates artificial grape, because it's purple. Well, actually, I used to really like artificial grape cough syrup because it tasted really good. But then they changed the formula, and then it started to suck. These little axe ghosts are... can be somewhat annoying, but not really. Have I talked about the axe ghosts before? I don't know. God. Bite me. I don't know how these zombies are considered a threat. All they do is barf, and that's just annoying. Come on. Come on. Thank you. I am so bad at the easiest whip jumps. That does not look good for the future. Skull guy. Spartacus. Can be somewhat annoying unless you keep knocking him over with strong attacks. If you keep that up, well, he's nothing. Neither are these dog skeletons. Dog, wolf, same thing. They're both canines. And there's nothing off this way, it's just a little aesthetic touch. And just another potion up here. And I can't seem to grab them and use them at the same time. Oh, you have to use that quick menu to use items and equip stuff. You can't do it from the pause menu. I'm not sure how this works, but sometimes if you hit that peeping eye, it acts like a bowling ball and knocks over the skeletons. If you can manage to knock over all the skeletons, you get a healing item. I think it's called ramen. And another switch. This is the final of the optional switches. You don't have to come here if you don't want to, but it does get a pretty good item. Well, not good item, but useful to get another good item. And down this hallway. This is a kind of interesting room. Well, not really interesting, but see that peg? Jump on it. As you can probably guess by that sweeping camera angle, you have to whip jump across those conveniently placed poles. Gotta get a good rhythm down, and boom. I almost never do that my first try, so I'm kinda happy about that. This is a really bad camera angle. Thankfully, all it leads to is some stairs downward. Hey, new music. And a somewhat creepy area. Not that creepy. I mean, I'm not gonna have nightmares from it. In addition to these axe ghosts, we have a new enemy. It's really annoying astral fighters, as they're called. They warp around and just swing their swords. If you're not used to them, they might kill you. They really might. Just keep moving and swinging your whip around. Guard when necessary. Come on, you guys are annoying. See those statues? Memorize that pattern. Might want to write it down. And this is a big, this big guy here is an executioner. When he hits you, he curses you, and when you're cursed, you can't use any special combos. Like that. He's big, he can take a lot of punishment, but he's not that bad. His attacks are fairly well telegraphed, and unless you're stupid like me, you won't get hit. Pay attention to that pattern, too. And this is the room we want those patterns for. When you whip a statue, it rotates. That's not what I wanted. Like, girl, goat. Goat. Nope. Girl and goat. And the door over here opens. There's another door in the room. I'll show that off a bit later. Here we have poison zombies. And a new extension combo. As you can guess, poison zombies, well, obviously they paralyze you. They're not that big of a deal. I don't think I've ever been affected by them. I mean, they're just zombies. Except with poison. I don't see the Astral Fighters as a bigger threat. And in this doorway, we have some evil swords. Really, that's what they're called. A few strong attacks and they go down. And in here, we have our first accessory, the Bloody Cape. Whenever you get damaged, you get some hearts back. It's good if you like using sub-weapons and getting hit a lot. I don't use sub-weapons that often, and I don't get hit a lot. I prefer not to get hit. There's another combo with these statues. Always hit the ones I don't want to hit. Go goat, girl. The other door opens. And you want this door, because inside of it is a health up. And back out of here. Check down that other doorway we have yet to enter. Well, one of the two. The far one. Go through this hallway. Hi, Mr. Executioner. Bye. Yeah, I don't want to deal with you guys. Except you hit me anyway. That green, too, means the hearts were recovered. I haven't used any hearts, so there's nothing to recover. And this. And this is that second doorway the switches were opening. And we head down here, and oh crap, it's you guys again! Really hate these stupid archers. Stop that. Stop it. Nobody likes you. Ow. Just had to get that last hit in, didn't you? In here is the white tiger key. Made up notice the yellow door earlier on. This door key will open a door like it. If I can speak. And we are almost done with this place. Just gotta get to the save point that's up close. Oh yeah, I forgot about this place. Those wooden planks you can't jump on. They will break and you'll drop into the place below where there's some enemies. Just jump right back up. It's more of an annoyance than anything. But that's all the time I have now for Let's Play Castlevania Lament of Innocence. I'm Buppix, I'll see you next time when I fight the boss. Bye.